Geraldine, what is it like? This is inspiring news from Charlie Hebdo, but talk to us about what it's like to be in Paris today.
Well, like you said, we're on the edge here. The shooters haven't been arrested yet, even though we understand that some operations are ongoing. There's also been another shooting this morning, and the prosecutor's office said they were treating this as another terror threat. So yes, people are on the edge. People want to see these people arrested, and people want to understand why, even though one of the shooters from yesterday's terror attack against Charlie Hebdo was known to the police for being an Islamist fundamentalist, was still able to roam freely around Paris and commit such an horrific action.
Then, given the terror threat and the fact that these suspects haven't been arrested, though it's noble, couldn't it be considered very dangerous to continue to be so bold and print next week's issue?
Sorry, can you please repeat? I didn't get that.
The fact that they want to go on and print, did you say a million copies?
A million copies.
Couldn't that be construed as maybe reckless and dangerous at a time when you don't need more danger?
Freedom of press, expressing it, showing that they're not scared, they're not afraid, and that they endeavor to do what they've done all these years, like bowing to pressure, whatever the pressure is, and however deadly it can be, alas.
Well, Geraldine, you may have seen Richard Malka, who is the lawyer for Charlie Hebdo, spoke to France Info Radio today and said, quote unquote, we can't let them win. And that is the sentiment, if you will, behind the decision to print a million copies of the magazine. Let's talk about the potential that this event and its aftermath has to change the political discourse in France. What do you perceive thus far? Once again, I am sorry, folks. We are having some technical trouble with our camera in Paris.
There's so much activity in Paris right now. It's actually affecting the bandwidth coming out of there, and that's the cause for all these technical issues.
You can imagine the world is the world, and that's no exaggeration given the number of statements that we have heard from global leaders, from heads of state. The world is paying very close attention to what's happening in France because it is so symbolic in many ways. It's not just a tragedy, it's a tragedy for every democracy and everybody who believes in freedom of expression. I think we may have Geraldine back up. Geraldine, are you there?
Yes, I am.
So I think you may have heard my question. I wanted to know a little bit about the potential that this event has to change the political dialogue in France.
Yeah, well, I think it has already been mentioned earlier today that the French political arena has already been very much, polarized, and the far right was doing extremely well. It's going to embolden them further. Initially, they were, rating high thanks to the bad economic performance, thanks to, a very high, even a record high unemployment rate. Now they've got another case. It's strengthening their case. They're doing very well on the fears of, security issues. It definitely gives them a case of the current government is kind of weak regarding security. It also gives them a case to show how strong or right they were to flag all these fears, to say that the government was weak, has been weak, and remains weak. And here's the proof in one of these worst terror attacks that Paris has seen actually in years.